To those of us in the UK, it seems like System of a Down have been away for ages and ages. They haven't played here for quite a while, and the debut album came out now 3 years ago, but they're back with album number two, and Serj and Daron are here on the right to talk about it. You all right?
Yep.
How you doing?
So, 3 years since the debut album. That's quite a long time for a band to leave between their first album and their second release. When did you actually start working on this new album?
When we finished the last one. Writing is something we always do. It's not really necessarily just writing for an album. It's something we do all the time.
So I heard that for this album, over that period of time that you've been doing writing, you'd sort of narrowed it down to 33 tracks and then sort of argued between band members about 14 tracks that were actually eventually going to be featured on the album. But not what was good or bad, what had the most cohesive direction. What kind of direction did you decide this album should have?
We didn't argue too much.
No, not at all. It was hard picking it though, because there were a lot of songs and, as far as direction, it's more of like whatever fits together, more importantly than which specific songs ended up being on this one.
I'd say there's a more melodic direction to the record.
So a deliberate, more softer approach to this album.
Not softer, just melodic.
Just melodic, yeah. I've got this theory, right? Let me see what you think about this. That the new metal is going to be prog rock. Because I don't know if you've noticed this, but there's all these bands that are coming out now with lots of complicated guitar bits, and they're going more melodic and stuff like that. And it would seem, not deliberately, but just by chance, that that System's going more in that direction.
I think it's because me and him do more vocal harmonies in certain parts. I mean, if you know System of a Down music, you know it goes from one place to another within a second. We'll go through a really heavy thrash part, and then me and him will do like this really pretty beautiful vocal melody type of thing. And that was something that you couldn't find on the last record. It sometimes takes about 8 to 9 months, sometimes a year, to put a System of a Down song together, and it's because it's easy to put things into a song, and you just keep putting things into a song. The hardest part is to take the stuff out. Because you generally do like all your ideas, but you have to figure out which one of your ideas works best for that song.
Right.
And you don't want to overdo it and make... When you put too much, the song sort of loses itself after a while and loses the song aspect of it all, which is, you know, a verse chorus type of thing. We like to stay on that verse chorus type of tradition, except, you know, sometimes the verse will be a waltz and the chorus will be hardcore.
Rick Rubin has produced this album again. I would imagine that
along with me and him.
Yeah, I would imagine he probably is very good for System of a Down, in so much as if you look at the kind of stuff that Rick Rubin's worked on before, he's worked with everyone from like Mick Jagger solo to the Beastie Boys, right?
Yes.
And you as a unit are kind of like amalgamate everything that he's done. Is that why you work with him again?
That's a big reason why I think we chose Rick.
Rick's very easy to work with. He's very calm and, you know, he complements our vision.
I think he helps us a little bit with pre-production. He always tries to bring out the strongest points of the song, like make them shine.
He's helped a lot with even lyrical ideas and things of that sort, where things were like, should we repeat this or should we maybe do something different? And, you know, he's a good think tank for that purpose as well.
Well, we're talking about lyrics. Serj, you write a lot of poetry, and people can get poetry in books and via the websites and stuff like that. And of course, the lyrics for System of a Down. How do you decide what becomes poetry, what becomes lyrics for songs, that kind of thing?
Generally, when I write words, I just write words. But with System songs, Daron came up with a lot of lyrics on this one, so he'd come up with an idea usually, or if he didn't, then, you know, I'd look through poetry that I've written or something like that. But generally on this album, I've written a lot of stuff based on the vibe of the song, fresh and new, you know, or cut in stuff as well from, you know, just whatever. Whatever's meant to come there, that's what comes there.
How are you finding being with a major label now? Because it occurred to me, you know, System of a Down, it's a big new album that's coming out, this second album for you. The markets have all gone rock at the moment. The first album sold nearly a million copies. Were the record company kind of breathing down your neck while you were making this album, seeing what
Not
it sounded
really.
Like?
Not really. It was actually very, you know, we said that we're going to take time after touring and not be a band that comes up with a second album really quickly right off tour, because I think that's a mistake. You don't have time to reflect and grow and present yourself differently.
Nobody ever tells us what to do, actually. And that's it's funny because I hear that and I always wonder, you know, how much does the record company get involved with other bands like that are in Colombia? because they don't come to rehearsals or anything. Because kick them out.
Do you not feel any kind of pressure that might come afterwards about the expectations that the record company might have? I mean, would you be disappointed if this album doesn't do a million like this?
We write music for ourselves, you know. Ultimately, like, people would tell me not to growl or else we'll never get signed and things of that sort. If we're going to listen to them, then we'd be in a bad place to start with. It doesn't matter.
Before we started doing any press or anything, like, when we completed this record, I'm so emotionally attached to these songs that if we sold two copies, I'd be surprised. but I would also, at the end of the day, still be satisfied and say, we did write a good record. Mm. The songs aren't exactly very radio-friendly. If you listen to the radio, you wouldn't hear anything that sounds like our new record. So.
Plus, it's hard for them to react that way because we've got this frequency that we've developed that we've put on the record that'll make people shit.
Okay.
It really does. It makes you shit.
So the Sgt. Pepper had the thing that makes your dog bark, but System of a Down have taken it way beyond that.
Fecal Fecal matters.
Okay. Even if your dog's really well house trained, it's just gonna it's gonna lose control, right?
Wouldn't that be great to actually control bowel movements from stage?
Music is a powerful thing, man.
Absolutely, it can move you, even your bowels, right?
All of you.